Hey, hey, party people, it's Lycona Dacheechee, and welcome to Eden's Gate, Resurrection Savage, the Easy Peasy Guide, also known as E1S. Now, before we start, each party member should take a cardinal direction point, and the party members who are on the cardinal directions should choose a partner on the diagonals, as this becomes important later in the fight. We put our markers here, as you can see. They don't really have a big significance now, but they will later in the fight. First up, she'll cast Eden's Gravity, which is just a party-wide AoE. Next up, she'll cast Vice and Virtue, which places little target markers on the four DPS. Once they go off, the DPS will drop an AoE around them, so make sure to take it to the outside on the cardinal directions. Now, at this point, it really doesn't matter where the DPS drops it now, but later in the fight, you're going to have to do the same mechanic again, and if you drop these AoEs on the diagonals, you're going to be covering the safe spots with these AoEs. So it's best to practice dropping them on the cardinal directions, away from the middle. After the party drops those AoE puddles away from the boss, everyone should come back into the middle to stack underneath the boss to dodge Eden's Flare, which is a donut AoE. After that, she'll cast Vice and Virtue again, but this time she'll put the markers on the two tanks. A laser beam will hit both tanks at the same time, so the tanks should not be stacked on top of each other. Healers should top them up quickly, as there are tank busters right afterwards called Spear of Paradise, and each tank takes a pretty big hit, so pop your cooldowns. Immediately after the tank busters, she'll cast Vice and Virtue again, which puts the target markers on the healers. But this time, the healers have to pass the markers to someone else, or else they're going to die. So in our case, each healer passes it to their tank. Since the healer marker can be passed to anyone in the party, the healers should be a little bit outside of the party by themselves before they pass it to the tanks. Right after that, she'll jump to a corner, so the entire party should run behind her to dodge the AoE. After that, run back to the center and get ready for Delta Attack. Now, here's where the markers become important for the fight, as well as your diagonal partners. Each person will get an AoE around them, so you want to space yourself out in this configuration in the diagonals. Range and heals should be on the corners, while tanks and melee can take the inside. An AoE will also appear around the boss, so for melee, you'll have to disengage. If you stand behind those markers, you'll comfortably dodge Eden's inside AoE. There's also these little triangle designs on the floor, and if you notice closely, you'll see that they form sort of a circle in the middle of the stage. This circle is the approximation of Eden's AoE range, so if you're standing on those patterns in your diagonals, you'll be safe from that inside AoE. Next up, Eden will place down 8 orbs. Soon after that, AoEs will appear on 4 party members. Now, these AoEs can be baited by the party members who are furthest away, so range and healers would be ideal. These AoEs will appear 5 times. After the 5th AoE, everyone should get right behind their orb, as each orb will laser beam the closest person to that orb. Directing the beams to the outside of the stage will make sure that no one gets hit with 2 beams accidentally. Immediately after, she'll jump to a corner, so just run behind her to dodge the arena-wide AoE. When she jumps back to the middle, she'll cast Dimensional Shift, which is just a party-wide AoE. And right after that, she'll cast Fragor Maximus to start the add phase. Hang out on the side for a little bit, and when the two adds come down, each tank will take their own add and tank them appropriately. They don't cleave or tether together, so we just group them up, like so. It doesn't matter which add you kill first, but you must kill one at a time, as their party-wide AoEs get stronger the longer they stay up. Both adds must be silenced, so everyone, be ready for that. After you take down the last add, put the game down and go grab yourself a coffee, because we're going to be sitting here for about 1,000 years watching this cutscene. But through the magic of editing, welcome to the second phase. First up, you'll want to get into your left and right groups. So 4 folks on the left and 4 folks on the right. Eden will cast Vice and Virtue, and little target markers will appear on the tanks, as usual. But this time, the tanks need to share the laser damage with their group. Each tank should line up on the outside of their group, and the other 3 party members of each group should line up between their tank and the boss, like so. 2 ginormous laser beams will come out and hit both tanks, as well as their respective groups. Now, you don't want to be inside Eden's hitbox at this point, because you'll get hit with both lasers and die, so be pretty careful here. The reason why we're so scrunched up here is so that the tanks can also continue to DPS. Next up, Eden will cast Vice and Virtue again, and this time the 4 DPS will get target markers, but you want to go to your diagonal partner and share the AoE damage like so. Right after that, the party should stack on the butt, while the two tanks separate themselves on the diagonal positions as you see here. The party will get a shared AoE damage, while the two tanks will each get their own AoE buster, hence why the tanks need to be a little bit separated here. Don't go too far out from Eden, as there's another donut AoE that happens around her. Next up, the healers will get the target markers on their heads, and will need to pass it to the DPS. In our case, we had the healer swap their targets to the ranged DPS on markers C and D. Also be careful here, as the healer targets can be passed to anyone, so move out as quickly as you can away from the party. Once the DPS has the target, it will explode, giving them a bleed which needs to be healed accordingly. Immediately after that, Eden will cast Spear of Paradise, which is the double tank buster. Just as a note, you cannot give these targets to the tanks, because when the targets explode, that person gets a physical vulnerability debuff, meaning the tanks will die when they get hit with their tank busters. The next mechanic is Dimensional Shift, and she'll spawn four orbs that have rotational indicators around them, as well as four meteors. A lot happens during this mechanic, so let's go over each part one at a time. First, the middle of the arena is the safe spot. Second, each orb will shoot out three separate laser beams. Like the orbs in the first phase, the closest person to each orb will bait the laser beams in that direction. When the orb fires their lasers, those beams are going to rotate depending on the rotation indicator. Knowing this, we can then figure out how to bait the orbs by standing next to them in a particular place, so that we bait the rotation of the laser beams to the outside of the arena and keep the middle of the arena safe. For the two orbs on the outside edges, you want to place your character on the side of the orb that's going to rotate the lasers towards the outside of the arena. For the two inside orbs, you want to place your character on the diagonal so that the laser rotation also goes to the outside of the arena. Once you see the orb's laser AoEs on the ground, you can then move into the middle for the safe spot. Don't forget to kill the meteors in the middle, because if you don't, they're going to wipe the party. How we do this mechanic is for a range to take the north side orb and a healer to take the south side orb. The two tanks will each take an orb in the middle. This frees up the two melees and a ranged DPS in the middle to DPS the meteors down, as well as a healer to obviously heal the party. Since the orbs could spawn in any cardinal direction, we simply rotate clockwise from our static north-south positions, meaning that the person who usually gets the north orb will now pick up the east orb, and the south person will pick up the west. At this point, you've seen all the mechanics of the fight, so it's just rinse and repeat until you guys get that clear. After the orbs, Eden will jump to a corner, so just have the party run behind her and dodge her raid-wide AoE. She'll then cast Dimensional Shift, which is a party-wide AoE. Next, she'll cast Eden's Gravity, which is another party-wide AoE. And then she'll cast Eden's Flare, which the entire party should stack underneath her. Next up, she'll cast Vice and Virtue, which are the two targets that go on the tank for tank lasers. Spear of Paradise comes next, which are the tank busters. Now remember what I said at the beginning, where the DPS would have to drop their AoEs on the cardinal directions? Well, this mechanic is it. She's going to cast Vice and Virtue again, and then immediately after you need to run to your diagonal safe spots for Delta attack. It hits pretty hard, so healers, you definitely want to put up some shields for this part. Next up, she'll cast Vice and Virtue again, which targets the two healers, and now all the healers have to do is pass these to the tanks like in the first phase. Next, you'll get the four rotational orbs and meteors, so handle them like last time. After orbs, she'll jump to a corner, so have the whole party run behind her to dodge her AoE. Dimensional Shift comes out again, as well as an Eden's Gravity, so heal the party accordingly. And finally, Eden's Flare, which the entire party should stack in the middle underneath her. And that's it! All in all, it took us about 3 hours to learn and clear this fight, with the rotational orb mechanic giving us the most trouble. But hopefully you've found this guide helpful so you can challenge Eden's Gate Resurrection Savage. Also keep in mind that new strategies for handling these fights evolve over time, so this guide might not reflect the current meta. But hey, it's a good start. Also, check out the links below for all the other ES1 guides that I've found that can help you and your team get your clears. Don't forget to like, favorite, and subscribe if you think this guide kicked butt and helped you out on your adventures in Z Fantasy. And thank you guys so much for hanging out with me. Until next time, keep on adventuring.